this is the opening spread of a short booklet that I've created about a trip that I took to Cuba. And you can see that I have multiple pages here. It looks good. But you know what the problem is with this document? Look up here, the master pages. There's nothing up here. I was so gung-ho about laying out the text and the pictures for this booklet, I didn't bother to create masters. And now I want to add many more pages and a bunch more chapters, and it's going to be really difficult to duplicate the exact layout and dimensions of things here on other pages. So obviously that means I need a master page. Also, I don't have anything with the footers and the page numbers. But if you're in this situation, if you need a master and you want it to look exactly like one of the pages in your document, you can easily convert a document page to a master page. Now, obviously, I don't want these pictures and text on the master. I don't want that repeating everywhere. But I do want placeholders for them, and I do want this blue bar going across the top. So how do you create a master page from an existing document page? There's a couple ways. First, in the Pages panel, make sure to target the page numbers underneath the pages that you want to convert to a master page. Actually, you're not going to convert these to a master page. You're going to convert a copy of these. You're not ever going to harm or change your existing document pages, so don't worry about that. Why the page numbers, not just this page? Because this is a facing pages document, and you always want to have facing pages masters. And double-clicking the page numbers underneath them selects the entire spread. Now from here, you go to the Pages panel menu, go down to the Master Pages flyout, and choose Save as Master. There you go. So you see the pages themselves stay the same, but up here we have a new master. And because the original pages were based on Master Page A, then Master Page B is also based on Master Page A. So I'm switching to the B master. We're looking at the B master. Let me go to normal view, and then I would just delete the content here just to have all the placeholders. I don't really need a placeholder for this image. That was just for fun, but you know, I would put some lorem ipsum text here for title page, or even just leave it blank, and now I could call it my new master. Another way to create a master, let's say we wanted this spread here to be a master, is I can just drag and drop it right up here. I don't have to hunt and try to remember where that command is. So again, target both pages. Of course, if you have a single if you don't have a facing pages document, if it's just single pages, then you don't have to target the page number, just the page itself. And then I'm just going to drag and drop it right up here. Bunk, there you go. And again, it names it CMaster, but it's based on Master Page A. If you don't want them based on each other, you can just right-click on the master, go down to Master Options for that master, and say Based on None. All right, so it exists on its own. There you go. It's really easy to convert an existing document page to a master page, and master pages are always smart to use in a long document. Hey, I hope you found this tip helpful. Be sure to check out InDesignSecrets.com for thousands of InDesign articles, to listen to our podcast, and to download a free sample issue of our monthly magazine called InDesign Magazine. Thanks for learning with us.